catch them in the pasture, run them in the pen, work them on the Sundays, do it all again. Race them in the sand, buck them in the mud, drip a cowboy's sweat, bleed a cowboy's blood.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Cowboy stuff. That's what's going on. That's what we do. And yeah, you are tuned in once again to the Pepper Stewart Show. Why you watch, I don't know. I don't want to ask. I don't have a clue. But you do. So that's, you know, we're here.
Howdy, fellas.
That's right. Stuff's going on. Stuff is going on, folks. We're here. You're here. Everybody's here. We are also live on the Book of Faces for those of you Book Faces watchers like to what do they call those voyeurs? You voyeur types that like to be on Books of Faces, kind of like Tex. He's over there.
I've been called that a few times, voyeur.
He's been called that a time.
Maybe I don't know. Maybe something different.
What?
This is not something we need to talk about.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Would y'all stop people? Y'all texting? You know the show? Well, I guess they don't know. I was gonna say where those of you watching, not watching live, are like, what are you talking about? Those of you watching live are like, what? It's a different day. Well, yeah, Thanksgiving.
It's in 2 days.
Yeah.
I'm going home. I'm going to down south for Thanksgiving. You got any plans?
Yeah. I'm going to eat some turkey. That's my plan.
Yeah. I ate turkey last week, but I'm going to eat turkey again.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I do that.
My church had Thanksgiving early.
They always do. They want to make sure they get everybody gets a bite. Everybody's got to
donate.
Get a bite of turkey. Oh yeah.
You live again? What?
What? What happened?
I don't know.
Who did it?
Yeah.
You did it.
Apparently you went live again. I don't know.
That's right. We did. We did that twice in one day. We are here on the Pepper Stewart Show. We got stuff for you guys today. Let me rattle through what we got coming up for you. We're going to talk about stuff, right? We're going to talk about some stuff. We've got some things going on here. Take a look at that. PBR results. We got some PBR results for you. And there's some stuff going on this holiday weekend, Turkey Day weekend. Stuff's going on, so we'll tell you about that.
I think we got a little article in there about the PBR. I think they're replaying it or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Or maybe they're going to have it again. I don't know.
We'll find out. We'll find out later on in the program. We got some cattle prices for you. We're going to talk about that deal. Some cattle prices. And
hey, Kate Lane.
An Aussie cow took down an airplane. We're going to tell you about Australian cows, man. They took down an airplane. So we're going to tell you about that.
Hey, Kevin.
We're going to talk about some rescue stuff. Some horses rescued from a rescue. What does that mean? And
hey, Melina.
Well, you got a shout-out list going on over there?
Yeah.
You got a shout-out. Live shout-out list going on. Tex on fire. He's on fire. A cat in Sweden. We need to call. You know, we call Sweden from time to time. Of course, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. We call them. But we call from time to time and talk to those folks. And maybe we can get a hold of this cat that rides a horse. We're going to tell you about that.
Probably do better than I can on a horse.
And we got some good stories, man. We got corn on the roadway and snakes on a plane. What? How's that work? How does that work? The Bronx Zoo set a record, and there was another cat. We got another cat story from New Zealand. But we need to wait on we got another straggling here to the show today, so we're going to get them here. We got some more interesting information.
That's not a joke, son.
Apparently
he is coming.
Yeah. That's what they all say, right?
Maybe.
Yeah. That's what's going on. We are here. You are here. You are tuned in and watching, so that's a good deal. There's some events going on in Amarillo in December. We're not talking about
Amarillo by morning.
We're not talking about NFR stuff's going to be going on. And if you're at the NFR, check this out, man. Spurs the Word right there. Spurs the Word is going to be at Country Christmas downtown right there at the pavilion. Go down there, check it out. They'll be there December. So Spurs, you get your Spurs the Word gear while you're down there. Be a good deal going on. And then you also got the Black Friday special right here. So how about that? Is that like a blowing your mind right now? Black Friday deals right there. Rustic Nation Outfitters. Go get outfitted in some Rustic Nation gear, right?
Do I got to wake up early for it? They can open up at 3 o'clock in the morning?
No.
On Friday?
I don't think that's what's going on. You just go order and put in a special code that we got right here on the screen for you. Or did have on the screen for you.
Oh, so I don't have to wake up early in the morning. I just
it's
don't.
20. It's, you just put in code RN025. And you get 25% off your entire order. Free shipping over $75 bills, man.
I don't have to leave my pajamas.
No. Pajamas, Ugg boots, you're set and good to go, man. Mm-hmm. You will be styling and profiling in your Rustic Nation gear. Bucking bulls. Everybody, don't forget your bucking bulls for Christmas. Come on, now let's get some bucking rank flanks in there. Let's flank these bulls. And you, as you know, that when you order the purple flanks from Bucking Rank Bull Flanks, 20% goes to help all-timers with the Get Fit Pit to end. Oh, timers right there. Watch out for Bonnie the Ninja. She just might karate chop you. That might happen. It might. I don't know. That's Tex. I think he's in line for a karate chop.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not talking about her significant offering.
Did you get lost or what? Did you get lost in thought? Forget what you're talking about? Did you forget? Look at this. Champions Roughstock right here. Check this out, man. Champion Roughstock, the Champion Roughstock Challenge, December 31st, Friday, Saturday. We're going to talk to the man with the plan with that deal right there here in a little while. So we're going to talk to him. We'll probably throw a tune out first and burn your ear holes and come back to you with some information. We got a lot of stories. Guys, we have a lot of stories for y'all, so we may only get to throw out one tune or two because we've got, man, I mean, we got stuff. We got like, look at there. Rodeo Joe's on fire. Mm-hmm. He sent a couple of good stories over. You might want to check them out. Even the Moo Call's got a story out on the Moo Call. We got to give this Moo Call away at some point so you can have your cow text you when she's having a calf. Because that is how it works. Yes, your cow can text you when she's having a calf. True story. Moo Call. Check it out. We got one. Where's that text? We got one. Show it to the folks.
Moo call. And moo! Moo hoo hoo! Moo! Moo! I don't know what camera am I looking at.
I don't know. You're looking at the one looking at you, I guess.
You know, I probably give this to a gal in Oklahoma.
A what?
A gal. I went to.
Oh, a girl. A gal.
A gal. A gal in Oklahoma.
Oh, yeah?
A woman. A lady. A lady uh-huh. friend. She, you know, she was her grandchild, farmer only.
Yeah.
And I went to cheat one time.
Yeah.
And I ain't never cheated again. She brought the, I found a caller, text her, and she won't return my call.
Yeah.
And she said, this number is no longer in service. I don't know. So she must not like the new car idea. But maybe y'all like the new car idea.
Maybe she thought you were telling her something.
Yeah. Y'all know. I all I told her about it, do you want to keep a cow or whatever? I didn't
maybe you said she was a cow. I don't know. Maybe we figured this out. So you told her she looked like a cow. No. You moved collar.
I was drinking, but I wasn't drinking that much. I don't know.
Speaking of drinking, we're going to throw a tune out here for you from one of the nominated artists for the American Western Artist Awards right here. We're going to throw them in your ear holes. It's L.M. Stone. Check this out, man. This is going to get your toe to tapping. You're going to want to go strolling and rolling across the dance floor when you hear this tune.
Darling, my love for you is stronger than the wine in this bottle that I'm holding in my hand. you help me take control of my emotions so the bottle won't take control of me. This bottle that I'm holding is making me your love for me is empty, and it will fulfill my needs. Oh, darling, can you please just lend a helping hand so the bottle won't take control. I know it's wrong to hold on to this bottle when I should be holding on to you. So please, won't you help me take control of my emotions so the bottle won't take control of you. This bottle that I'm holding is making me believe that your love for me is empty, and it will fulfill. Just lend a helping hand so the bottle won't take control of me. This bottle that I'm holding is making me believe that your love for me is empty, and it will fulfill my needs. Oh, darling, can you please just lend a helping hand so the bottle won't take control of me. Don't let that bottle take control of you.
Donkey show, what going on, folks? We're back, Cracker Jack.
Hey, Katie. Hey, Melina.
What?
Did I miss one?
What are you doing?
Give a shout out again.
Shout outs to what?
This is not Hot 104 Point Jams or whatever.
What?
You don't do shout outs.
Oh, I can give a shout out to my fans.
Luke is here. Eric is here. You may want to raise up your talking device.
Microphone.
There you go.
Phone.
Pretend like your text on Saturday night. Phone. You're right up on it.
Long. Woo.
Echo.
We got the California kid over here.
I thought he changed his name.
Oh,
I don't have a name.
He's the man with no name. The man with no name.
My name is Nobody. You ever seen that movie? Yeah.
He saw that once, twice.
I am going to California tomorrow, but
California, hey, is what they say. Here's what we're gonna talk about real quick. Let me ring a ding ding this feller and see what he's talking about.
Nobody talking.
What?
That's why, because he broke it.
He broke it. But that happens, he does that. Yeah. What happened? Oh, we were calling somebody.
Link.
What?
After their turn. There we go.
You're back.
You got delays.
Hey, y'all.
7 seconds.
Hey, Charlotte.
Yep. Hello.
McGraw. Quick draw, McGraw. Mm-hmm.
Hello. Can you hear me now? We're ring-a-ding-dinging. We were ring-a-ding-dinging.
I don't hear it.
I don't know. We've been playing with these.
Mine freaking up, too. Don't worry.
Everybody's freezing up.
Hello.
Hello, there you are. There you
are. Hey.
He's here. He's here, guys. We are live on the Pepper Stewart Show. Oops, seeing what's going on. Stuff's happening. We're getting...
I tell you what, I appreciate you calling me on this wonderful evening here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we understand. Once I get this thing to pop up here. Yeah, there we go. The Champions Roughstock Challenge in December up in Amarillo. What is going on with that?
Well, it's actually the Championship Roughstock Challenge. A couple years ago, me and a buddy were driving, hauling some bulls, and we had talked about Amarillo being a great place to put a bull riding, and I'd been to the Chase Hawk several years ago, and I just thought that concept was phenomenal. Then there were some other Roughstock associations at the time, and so we started it, and it's been quite an undertaking. But this year is going to be kind of special. You know, we've been a one-night show up until this year. We've always had it on New Year's Eve, but this year we've added a few things and added some entertainers. And last year we had the Match of Champions, many bareback riders and bull riders. It was phenomenal. And so we've been pretty blessed to progress to where we're at now.
Well, it seems like you got a pretty action-packed lineup here from all age groups, it seems like.
Well, yeah, you know, I tell you what, when we first started, we've been really kind of, this is, you know, I don't say it's by accident, it's pretty much by design, but we've pretty much gotten lucky from the onset. The first year we had, we actually hosted an American qualifier with PRS at the time. That was our first year. So that was a pretty exciting deal for us, kind of coming out of the box like that. You know, we had Will Lowe winter bareback riding, Chandler Bound winter bull riding, and Dalton Davis winter broadcast. So we've had pretty darn good shows as far as contestants and livestock. So, you know, we've just kind of progressed into this point. And this year, I've kind of, you know, like I said, I'm the grunt to the graphics analyzer to every
Lost him?
Uh-oh. I think it got you. Did it get you? They said the grunt. I think they grabbed him.
That'll happen sometimes with the telekinesis telephone devices. It sends satellites through space, and it bounces off and comes back down, and every once in a while they don't make it.
Yeah, that happens sometimes. Let's try it. Let's do another one more. Let's ring a ding ding one more time.
Especially if you have T-Mobile.
Yes. Let's try it again. That may be what happened. He may be driving. He was driving earlier.
Somebody told me alien bounced around the Cadillac. That's what happened.
They lied to you.
The alien out of space, and they bounced around the Cadillac.
Well.
But now I don't know. I don't think I believe that.
What?
I would have believed that you had died of over again from the dead.
Well,
yeah.
I'll just do that, I guess. Whatever you want. You know, whatever diet you subscribe to, mental or physical.
I guess so.
Is the phone ringing?
Yeah, we'll try it one more time.
I figured. Got to do my little golf message every day. Go to Pepper, whatever, Stewart.com.
Or just say it out loud, whatever you want. Yeah, say Carl Ramrod. He put it on the paper.
We were talking to him. We were trying to find out about this championship Roughstock deal to see what was going on with that. Apparently, I talked to him earlier today. He was driving around, and it may be the case. He may be in an area that doesn't have
He may be trying to get back to Amarillo by morning.
I would try to do that if I was Amarillo. That's what I'd be trying to do.
I was anxious to find out the entertainers. He said they had entertainers. I want to know who's entertaining in Amarillo.
They are going to have, I don't know, his phone, we died out. And that's the thing with live show, folks. That's what it's all about. We are unscripted, as they say.
Sometimes it bees that way sometimes.
That's what happens. You know, we roll dog it. That's what it's all about.
Whoa.
We just go with the flow and put it out there to them. So.
Pause.
That just happened. So if you want to know more about the, of course, it's not till December 31st, so we'll have him on again. Before then, next couple of weeks, we'll talk to him again and see if we can get the cell cervix worked out. But they're going to have, many bulls, many bareback, saddle bronc. Then they're going to have senior bulls, saddle bronc, bareback, and then they've got the champion challenge. So they got a lot of stuff going on. So anyway, Google is your friend on that deal. Go to Pepper Stewart Show Facebook page in our events, and you will find the information on it because it's there. And
I got to find the information, I guess, to see who's entertaining.
Entertaining right there. Speaking of entertaining, New York City. You ever been to New York City?
New York City.
Get a rope. Yeah, I've been there. They just build on top of stuff. They keep going up. They ran out of space a long time ago, and they refused to admit it, so they just keep going towards the sky.
All right. Well, I got to
drive. I don't know.
Isn't the tallest building in the world in New York?
Is it the Trump Tower?
I think so.
No,
I believe that.
Well, I believe this. New York City, they offered me an opportunity to come to this deal, being all internet, social media, online stuff. So I was invited to this discussion on television and video.
Talking about what?
Tackling the complex conversation with online telecommunication stuff.
Like a TED Talk?
I don't know. It's part of the New York Television Festival.
I know there's a New York Comedy Festival coming up.
Did everyone notice that everyone here is wearing Masters Hatters of Texas from Masters Hatters of Texas? Google that. It
from
will
Garland
help you.
Land?
Garland,
you know,
Texas.
I got this. I tell you what. I got this Master Hatters hat when I was bald, see, because I was going to hide my hair when I grew it back. But the problem is, I got me a 7 1/8 from a big stupid head, and now I start growing my hair out.
You got hair.
And I need another.
You ain't had hair in 20 years.
It's getting a little tight. Yeah, I cut it off about 17 years ago, and here it comes.
It's coming back.
Look at that. Beautiful.
You got
this beautiful Brad Pitt and whatever movie that was that he was in that I watched once.
Yeah.
Coming back.
You can join the Marines. You can join the Marines now.
My Goldilocks. No, I can't. I'm too old for that. I might be able to join the Air Force.
You might be too old for Goldilocks too. All right. Here's anyhow. I don't know if they're gonna be upset at me. I don't know, but I'm not going to New York for the New York Television Festival to go. I don't know if they want me to go speak over there or go. I don't know. But this email came from the VP of Group Publishing, Broadcasting, and Cable. Multi-channel news.
Cable's almost over. We're on the interweb net.
Well, I know. And they want to discuss YouTubes, and it says YouTubes, and
who's tube?
I don't know. What?
YouTube?
Well, he is the vice president, so you must know something.
I don't know. They want.
He don't know as much
well,
as the president. I guarantee that.
Are they gonna be mad at me? I don't go to New York City, but you know, ask these folks in rodeo, especially ask avid video rodeo imager out there. I don't travel far. So New York City is out of my travel
vortex. From what I've heard on television commercials, they make terrible hot sauce.
They do make terrible hot sauce.
New York City.
Grab a goat.
Oh. Yeah.
All right, livestock market. Let me run this. Let me rattle down this right quick in your ear holes here. The market reports are out. Well, you know, it's kind of a fluctuation, a flux capacitor going on here.
Does this have anything to do with Donald Trump being elected?
It does. I don't. Well, no, because he hasn't contacted me yet. I put out there to him. Well, I put it out for him and him and her, whenever America was having a baby, and they wasn't sure if it was gonna be a male or female. And I put it out there and said, hey, whichever one of you yahoos want to come in here and talk about cow stuff, hey, we'll do it.
And they didn't accept. Imagine that.
Yeah.
They don't want to answer the real questions.
That's right. We want to know about cow prices.
Catch up. They don't.
Yeah. Because I'm gonna throw it down on them.
I would like to know what Trump eats on a hot dog.
I saw him on a picture of eating chicken. Fried chicken with a fork and a knife. So I want to know about. I want to know about that.
Hey, that's what they do in New York City. They eat fried chicken with a fork.
Yeah, that's like. Isn't there a law against that?
Up there, it's
I'm sure he'll change it.
That's what they do. I will. He also, what is he? He eats Mexican food on Cinco de Mayo in the top of his tower. Everybody said he didn't like Mexicans because he said he's going to build up some kind of structure. But he eats Mexican food.
Well, who don't?
Yeah, who don't eat?
Everybody eats
Mexican. Yeah.
Who eats cows? How about this? Steers. Your three weights. Check this out. Paris is high dollar this week. $1.25 to $2.45. On your three weights, your three to fours are $1 to $1.75. Your four to fives, $0.95 to $1.65. And five and up is 80 cents to $1.35. Packing cows, 35 to 60 cents. Your big bulls, 50 to 75. Your pairs. Top pairs. $1,250 to $1,600. Your low middles, $8 to $12.50. Your stalker cows were $6 to $15.50. Goats, Tex Travis, $100 to $150.
$150 for a goat?
I gotta get me a goat.
Not bad for Tex.
You can make a fortune.
I need to get me a goat.
That he could do.
I got a spare bedroom I can keep it in.
I bet you would too.
Okay then.
Emory, Texas, right here. Tex was there. They're down. They're still down. They're still down. 80 cents to $2.10. And what did we just say? Paris was $1.25 to $2.45. Emory's 80 cents to $2.10. So, if you're selling,
traveling up Paris.
Paris is a good deal. If you're buying, Emory's a good deal.
I'll be in Emory.
All kind of averages out about the same. Baby calves. Check this out, Tex. You might have to open up your spare bedroom once more because baby calves, $5.
Five
doll hairs?
$5
for a calf? For the whole thing or just a piece of it?
$5 to $3.75. Now, it's probably a Jersey bull with like a crooked leg or something, but $5 to $3.75.
Hey, I can bottle feed. I need something to bottle feed.
Yeah, I bet you do. Horses, $20 to $6.20. You drinking that milk? Goats, $25 to $300. Goats are high dollar over there. But hey, what do I know?
What's the deal with goats? You can eat goats $100-something. Calves is for nickel.
Yeah.
He's throwing them away.
That calf's probably a Jersey bull with a crooked leg. They sold me one of those one time.
It's because it's wintertime and they don't want to feed it.
He was on accident. He didn't say that.
Everything accident. I had an accident last weekend.
I know you did.
Jersey bulls, Jersey calves. Bull calves.
No, I bought a big lot of one time. We had a buyer looking for some stuff, and I went there and bought a whole lot of them. And they run them all in about 10 at a time because nobody you can get like $3 a piece for them things. And one of them had a crooked leg.
But they make good milk.
Yeah. So I let him have them all.
Lee,
I was like, I'll throw that one in for
Lee
free.
Lee was still alive. Lee wasn't dead.
Crooked leg.
Be eating later. Speaking of dead stuff, check this out. Speaking of dead cows, look at this here, what I got in my hand, folks. Let me zoom in on this deal. Look.
A dead cow.
Top hand gear right here. The knife is not included. The knife is for dramatization purposes only. This top hand gear right here. Made right here in McKinney or Frisco, Texas. Frisco, Texas. McKinney, Texas right here. Made in Texas top hand gear. These sheaths, they're the angled sheath right there. You put on your belt, you slip in your pocket knife right there. Do you need one? Do you want one? We're going to give some of these away. Probably
you can get a manicure like that.
Probably after Turkey Day. I don't know what Tex did. He's like getting a detailed manicure on his toes over there. After Turkey Day, we're going to give some of these away. So you guys want some of these? We're going to be giving these away. Knife? Not included, folks.
I know where you can go to Red River and get some of those, too.
Yeah, probably the right there. Look, what's the back of yours say?
I don't know.
Does it say Top Hand Gear?
Yeah.
Could be a coincidence. I don't know. But that's what we're going to tell you.
Mine said I'm in love with somebody at Red River.
What?
I would show mine off, but they're not a sponsor. So it's a little fancy gadget that I was given.
By Inspector Gadget?
By Inspector.
Wait, you got a you got a bottle opener and manicure kit.
It's like one of them Swiss Army knives. You ever seen that movie, Cool Runnings?
That's before my time.
Well, guess it wasn't that cool.
I'm watching Bible movies and stuff about Jesus.
No, you weren't. You were watching The Fox and the Hound and the show with the
Lady and the Tramp
on it. The Wishbone.
Wishbone, yeah.
I got a wishbone for you right here. How about this? Do you wish you were in Arlington, Texas for the PBR? If you use code Black Friday right here, look at that. Black Friday, BLKFRI, Arlington, Texas, Iron Cowboy. Of course, we will be there as we have been every year. Get two tickets for the price of one. Check that out. Buy one ticket, get one free. PBR, Black Friday sale. Jump on that deal. And speaking of the Iron Cowboy, the following day after the Iron Cowboy is the American. And what have we been doing since the American was invented? What have we been doing?
Giving away stuff?
Giving you guys tickets to it. That's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be giving away more tickets to the American 2017. So jump on that deal. Get your Iron Cowboy tickets. Go ahead and buy one, get one free. And then tune in to us here after Gobble Day. And we will hook you up with some tickets to the American. Speaking of PBR, let me throw this out here. Fabiano. I always have a funny story about Fabiano. Fabiano Vieira notched the victory in Newtown, North Dakota. Funny story is, back in the old days, in the old studio years ago, when Glarimay came in, he would come in all the time. When he'd come into the old studio and visit with us.
Mm-hmm. He had a restaurant down by there somewhere, didn't he?
I think that's a different Brazilian.
No? Okay.
That different one. Different Brazilian. When Glarimay came, Fabiano came with him. I didn't know who the guy was. I was like, oh, it's another Brazilian guy. But he didn't, he was unable to conversate at the time, so we couldn't, you know, conversate. But, yeah, another PBR superstar Brazilian right there.
That's the whole story? Right, he didn't talk?
No. I didn't speak Portuguese.
Portuguese?
Yeah.
That'd be tough.
Yes, that was tough. So, anyhow, Fabiano used a perfect 4-for-4 to get 340 points. In that performance to win the PBR, real-time pain relief velocity tour event on Saturday night at Four Bears Casino and Lodge.
Four Bears Casino.
Four Bears. Tex needs to go up there right now. The 34-year-old began the two-night event riding Ferdinand in round one for 86, roll your own for 84.5 in round two, and then kicked off things Saturday night with an 88.5. On Rand's Big Cadillac. Cody Nance, he won the... we got some Fabiano fans going on over here. We're on Periscope, too. We're on Periscope. We're on Facebook. We're on Ustream. We're on blah, 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 blah. You got to go to the... you got to go to the website. That's where we're at. All right, here we go.
Paul. Ain't showing nothing.
You're on the wrong page. All right.
What page we go
to? Are you on the website? PepperStewart.com. That's where you're going to watch it. Cody Nance won the championship round with 89 points on Set 'Em Up Joe, which propelled him to second place finish. Overall, he went 3-for-4. Wallace de Oliveira finished third place, and Diener Barbosa finished in fourth place. Derek Kobaba won round three on Saturday night, 89.5 on Hammer Down. Finished the weekend in fifth place. So that's your top five from the real-time pain relief velocity tour. If you don't know, now you know. You got a story over there you can tell me about?
I don't, but I got a story about Four Bears. We were talking about the Four Bears Casino.
Tex had Four Bears one night.
Only two.
That's DP.
One cub, two bears.
One bear, two cubs. What? One cubs, two bears? What do you got? You got a story about something over there? What's going on?
Bears. What is that about? The guy walked into a Chinese bar. That's what happened. He walked into a Chinese bar and asked for...
That sounds fake to me.
not yet, it ain't. we sat down at the bar. Bartender says, what do you like? He says,
three.
Give me a stoli. Or not. Yeah, give me a stoli with a twist. Bartender says, stoli with a twist, huh? Well, once upon a time, there were four bears.
What?
It pushed. I just got a push to it.
Stoli with a twist. What story you want?
Who
stoli you want?
Are you the bullfighter? That's for the Kevin Davis guy.
What are they talking about? What do you got? Tell me a story about it. You got a cow? I heard a cow took down a helicopter.
A cow from Australia?
Yeah, what happened to that Aussie cow?
Well, I'm not going to read it in an accent, I'll tell you that much.
I don't want to know that.
Australian cow takes down helicopter and walks off like a boss.
What?
That's the real headline. I didn't make that
wait,
up.
Whoa. Hold on. What just happened?
Australian cow takes down helicopter and walks off.
What did he walk off?
Like the drop that's supposed to play right now. Like a boss.
Yeah. All right, let's scrap that. Let's do one more time. All right, now what happened?
So the Australian cow apparently takes down a helicopter and walks off.
Like a boss. There we go. Look at that. We are geniuses here.
So the bovine revolution has begun, if you didn't know. A cow in Australia scuffled with a helicopter and tussled with a whale, and he handcuffed lightning and threw thunder in jail over the weekend. And the battle didn't end the way you might expect. When an unidentified chopper pilot tried to round up cows at a cattle station in Cowan on the Cape York Peninsula in Queensland on Sunday, things didn't go so well.
What?
Here's the aftermath posted on social media by Australian student pilot and aviation enthusiast, some fella. It's believed that the rails underneath the helicopter got tangled up in the cow's horns, causing the chopper to lose balance, the Queensland Police Service wrote on its website. While the chopper was utterly destroyed, the 35-year-old pilot of the Robinson R-22 Beta mustering helicopter was uninjured, except perhaps for his pride. And the cow, according to the Brisbane Times, the cow was just fine, like a
brilliant.
All right.
For real.
So the cow walked off with with his own song going on.
Really like a boss.
Yeah.
Utterly ridiculous.
Oh, yeah. But that Australians are crazy, they say. I don't know.
Down under?
That's what they tell me.
He said, that's not a helicopter.
This is a helicopter.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I don't know.
You done pumped the moo call a while ago, didn't you?
Yeah, I did moo call, but I forgot the details. I got a little detail about it.
Oh, you got details on a moo call? What are you talking about?
I forgot to say to him, 50-day money back guarantee on the moo call. So if you don't like it in 2 months, you can give it back.
Or you can just rent it for 2 months.
And I'll throw this out in your hole, too. If you want this moo call, you want to email us, we will send it to you and let you be our tester for the moo call so your cow can text you when she's calving.
They sold over 150,000 of them, so get one more. You need to get one, too.
That's a lot of baby calves.
150,000 customers own one.
Welcome, Punch!
So you need to get out there and be another customer, 151,001.
Oh, there you go.
I'm not in the market, but if you are, you send an email to Pepper Stewart, and he'll send you one over, and you can be the test tube baby.
There you go. Test it. Test it out, man. Test it out.
Yeah. Whatever.
That's what I forgot to mention. I forgot to mention about the 60-day money back guarantee. Money back.
Risk free.
So you know what?
Yes. How about this? I don't know. Did we talk about the PBR having the Thanksgiving Day special?
Thanksgiving?
We have not.
I'm going to be in a hotel in California. I might turn that on CBS. Is it regular CBS or is it the special?
No, CBS Sports.
See what happens?
Now do you resent your children?
And do the whole thing. But if you got DirecTV and all them magic dishes and whatnot, I'm sure you can get it.
You know what?
I mean, here it is.
CBS Sports Network will be telecasting a special PBR Thanksgiving Marathon, giving fans a second look at the recent 2016 Built for Tough World Finals. The marathon will run Thursday, November 24.
That's 2 days away.
6 in the morning till 8 in the p.m. Eastern Time. Covering all 5 days.
5 days.
Of the World Championship race from T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. The closest title race in history right there. Check it out. And who's going to win? We don't know. We'll tell you to watch it and see. If you don't know, you'll find out. If you already know, well, you already know, right? But what? Here's my question.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, spoiler alert is this. I posted this.
Spoiler alert, it's not really a spoiler because it already happened.
If you didn't watch it.
If you're a new fan, just logging on.
You might want to go watch it. How about I did.
It happened like a few weeks ago, though.
I did pose the question on, when I posted this, when they sent it to me and I posted it today on Facebook, I did leave a little caption on the bottom that said something about, I wonder if there'll be any edits.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of edits 5 days into one.
Well, I'm curious to what.
Out 4 days.
What about. Are there going to be certain rides,
people that
possibly?
Make it and people that don't make it?
Are there any possible rides that don't air?
You got TV-friendly stuff and not-so-TV-friendly stuff and people that are friendly with TV people and people that aren't friendly with TV.
Yes, and so that's going to be interesting because there's some folks that know what transpired with that deal, with the video that was there but then it was gone. So the curiosity is, what are they going to air? Will they air the ride? Will they not air the ride or two?
A video was deleted, but did it happen or did it not happen?
What? See, that's the thing. Somebody needs to watch this deal on Thursday and let us know.
It was. If it wasn't on video, did it happen?
That's what I want to know.
Yeah. If a rider falls
in the dirt and there's no dirt, does he get dirt in his teeth? What?
Yeah. Did it ever happen? Yeah.
The Pope and the bear ride the bull for 8 seconds or something. I don't know how to say it goes. Yeah. You figured out.
Does the goat milk the cow? Yeah. Or does the cow milk the goat?
Yeah.
What came first? The ride or the leash?
Oh, what did
I think it was Tex.
What did the Pope ride for 8 seconds? I don't know.
That's what he said.
Oh, Jeff.
Yeah, you pick one out of stat.
These aren't for me. Happy all read all this.
No. We haven't read anything. We have not. We didn't do any stories. So we're just waiting.
I saw a moo cow. I saw all kinds of stuff.
I want to do that. The football with text message. We got filed via text message.
Why? You having flashbacks or what? you know something about that?
Yeah, I got sympathy for the guy that got filed via the foot via text message.
What did he do?
So you know what? He dumped all. He was carrying corn. So he dumped all the produce. On the child of
Well, I tell you what, we didn't need it anyway. There's corn and everything.
Cornholio.
The Pennsylvania foot driver was arrested for allegedly. Allegedly.
Of course he was. Allegedly,
Nearly 1,000 bushels of corn on a Nebraska road after he was fired via text message.
What?
Via text message.
Yeah, he apparently did. Yeah. Yeah. He was arrested last week in connection with the August incident on Highway 8 in Royal Gay County.
Highway 8?
Horrible place to be. I can tell you that from experience.
He was driving a load of corn when he received a text message. You know what the text message is?
What'd it say?
It said, pack your stuff ASAP, and you can leave.
What?
Yeah? Was it from Donald Trump?
Come on.
Right around the election, and he said, you're fired.
I don't know. Why would you get that text while you're driving? I don't know.
First of all, understand at all,
he shouldn't
what
be
I'm
texting
saying?
And driving. That's why the guy got fired in the first place.
But they can't hear the text.
He shouldn't be reading it. See? That's the kind of guy you don't want behind the wheel.
Quit crazy. Taking yourself so damn seriously.
Even though it hit the police report now, the police report pulled the text.
Look at him. Got corn all over the ground like a seal. What is he? Feeding a deer?
It is
hunting.
Yeah. Oh, I got to get into that too. I was hoping Steve was here earlier today, and I was hoping he stayed around because a lot of folks get upset with me. And some folks got upset with me when I was talking about it on the Book of Faith the other day about that.
About
so,
hunting?
Yes. Or feeding, yes.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Finish your story there, Tex.
Well, you know, I think you had actually did. But, you know, the corn was put over a quarter mile due to the driver speeding off with the back door open.
He was going all back door on him.
Either way, he
back door in the cornholio.
Safe work practices.
the corn you kill on the road, it is valued at
$3,094. $3,094. This guy's driving down the road, left his cornhole open.
It cost him $3,000. You could left out of the back door.
Ridiculous.
And you That's know. Awful. The cleaner, it cost $500 to clean it up.
Clean that up. Can you imagine?
And
all those poor guys in orange suits going down there.
And they were saying.
And you had to pay every one of them.
The cleanup, should have cost $0. You know what you could say? He said, hey, all the farmers right there, hey, you know what? There's a whole lot of corn road. You want to go some feed for your cows or deer corn or whatever.
Just open deer season in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, you might have killed them because, so many people are mad at me. People are mad. They are upset at me on Facebook because I laugh in their face.
For what?
Because they keep posting these pictures of these big deer. And they're like, look, I went deer hunting, and I got a big deer. I'm like, dude, you've been feeding that deer for 3 months. He comes up to eat every day at the same time.
All right, you didn't hunt nothing.
You just went out there and caught him eating.
You go up to North Dakota, bring me back an elk, we'll talk about you hunting.
Yeah, come on. Now, let's do some real hunting. And then they tell me, well, do you hunt? Well, yes, I hunt. But if when I go hunting, I just go out there in the woods, and if I see something, bam. If I don't, well, hey, that's what happens. Right. And then I had one guy tell me, he was so mad. He says, I spent $6,000 a year on my deer lease to go hunt out there. I've got to make sure I get. I said, you spent $6,000. How much does that deer cost you?
How much meat can you really? You know, I go down to Hirsch Meats in Plano and just take the meat fairly. It don't cost me $6,000. I'll tell you that much.
For a year?
And cost me zero corn. I try to get corn out of my diet. You can't do it. I took a shot of B12 today from 7-Eleven. It had corn syrup in it.
They get shots.
Corns and everything.
I guess
get anything 7-Eleven.
I was gonna say, I guess they get flu shots too. They're too.
You get your shot of B12. You need.
Is that like I can't needle in you?
No, I'm not shooting corn syrup in my veins. If that's what you're asking, it's already there. I get that syrup in me.
Well, what I went on, I went around back in the alley about. Come on, offer me a shot. And they
take a drink of this. Was it Bill Cosby?
Yeah.
You have trouble sitting down afterwards?
And then I passed out, and then I woke up, face down, butt naked. I don't know what happened.
You swallowed a glass load.
Whoa, donkey show. All right. But, yeah, they get so mad at me when but I'm like, hey, you know.
Look, folks.
If that's what you do, that's what you do.
It's not hunting.
But don't call it hunting.
It's not hunting. You want to fight about it. It's like when you feed the fish and then you go catch the fish. If you put food out there on the lake and then you scoop them up with a net, are you really fishing or are you feeding the fish and then kidnapping?
Yeah, that's kidnapping.
Because you're putting corn, the deer's coming to eat, and you shoot it in the heart. It's not nice. What if you went to the steakhouse and somebody shot you in the heart, okay?
Yeah.
It wouldn't be fun.
Well,
it's not
like
hunting.
Well, it's like I told the guy.
You know what? It really don't matter. Hunting, not whatever you want to call it, is their sport. But if you ever watch a show with Steve Rinella called Meat Eater, that's hunting. The guy goes out there with a knife or whatever, and he goes and stabs rams in the neck in the mountains and stuff. That's a different story. That's hunting. He goes and kills bears and, you know, whatever he does. That's hunting. You're feeding and shooting.
Yeah.
Which is fine. I don't have a problem with it because it's delicious and I love to eat it.
That's how I hunt cows. I hunt cows the same way.
I look at my big trophy.
Yeah, I know.
Well, okay.
Well, that's how I could tell them. And I'm like, well, you hunt deer like I hunt cows. I'm like, what? What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I see it. I got these calves. I feed them up every day. I feed them at the same time. They come up there at the same time
and
every day.
I show up and I snatch one
right.
every once
and
in a while.
And when I get ready to eat one,
table.
Hey, same exact deal. And there's guys out there that have these new fancy. What sparked this random conversation was, I have game cameras up in the pasture. Because I like seeing pictures of stuff, you know. Because, yes, I'm looking for some hogs because the hogs have tore up a bunch of stuff. So I'm waiting on some hogs because, yes, I'm going to cook. I'm going to cook some more bacon. But, for one, I can't go put a bunch of stuff out because then the cows eat it. But anyway, so I had an area had a lot of traffic in it. So I put a camera up. And 2 days later, I get a picture. I've got it. It's posted on 7SC Ranch Facebook. There's a picture of a deer, a young buck, little spikes, looking directly into the game camera with his tongue out. Taking his tongue out at me.
Laughing at you.
And people were like, what? I want to come hunt. Blah, blah, blah. Where's your feeder? They were like, I don't see your feeder in the picture. I was like, there's no feeder out there, guys. This is where they come through the pasture. I put the camera up. It takes pictures of them. So I got some pictures of some does and little bucks and like that. And that's kind of what sparked the conversation. And I was like, when are you going to hunt? When are you going to get them? What are you going to do? Whatever. What are you talking about? They're travelers, man. Just leave them alone.
You get a picture of Bigfoot or a naked man walking through?
I think I did see you on the camera. Fishing. I think you were fishing down there. All right. And so with my
fishing, some people call it cruising.
I think it was noodling actually. And so with my catastrophe of the hunting aspect, let's dive into your story on rescue. What do you got over there? That was rescued from a rescue. What?
He's got a cat rescue.
No, we got a better one. We got a better one. Dig through there. Keep digging. Keep digging.
Rescue?
Oh, my gosh. I got something so
I got
entertaining here.
More entertaining.
Not, it's not as entertaining as, but it's more of a.
A kitten in a dishwasher and a kitten on a horse. Or rescue or not.
Yeah, rescue or not. What happened?
Rescue or not.
What happened?
As the children say, or the young people. I guess they're not children. They shouldn't be.
Tell me about that.
Melina, this is for you.
Melina Trump?
No.
I think it's Melania.
That's Melania. Yeah.
Either way.
You got to say it with an accent.
She's body positive. I like her. She's hashtag body positive.
Well, that's better than what you can be
like
positive.
Like Amy Schumer. Amy Schumer. She just gets naked and it's all fine, right? That's what we do.
I passed the positive test, too. You don't want to be my kind of positive.
All right. What happened to this positive? What's this horse? Is this horse positive? What's going on?
Okay, rescue or not. I don't know what that means, but I guess we'll all find out together. Nearly 50 horses have been seized from a Hill County ranch operating as a horse rescue. The Humane Society of North Texas, along with the Hill County Sheriff's Office, took the animals from the Thunderfoot Equine and Rescue. The horses were emaciated, injured, and several of them were near death. One horse had to be euthanized. Sandy Shelby, the executive director of HSNT, said the horses were living in deplorable conditions. They're Trump supporters. It wasn't a good place, said Shelby. It was a concentration camp. So they were Nazis?
What?
When you create starvation and suffering, that's pretty much an equal comparison. The Hill County Sheriff's Department confirms the woman running the horse rescue could face multiple felony charges of animal cruelty. Ooh. She is scheduled to appear before a civil court next Monday. The horses are now being treated at a ranch in Joshua. The veterinarians and volunteers will work to try to nurse them back to health. The HSNT is now asking for help in caring for these horses. They're looking for volunteers and donations to help treat the horses. So if you're a horse lover.
I got two volunteers for them right now.
Where?
I got me and myself.
Dr. Kenneth Noisewater.
Melina. Me and Melina can take care of those. We'll adopt the horses. A couple.
And that's where everybody gets all upset about packing plants being closed. Well, yes, packing plants, nobody likes that, but it's also a necessary evil like a lot of things in this country. And so what happens is...
You talk to that emaciated horse that had to be euthanized and ask him which one he wants.
Yeah. Would you rather have been healthy and put down in a humane way.
It's just kind of over.
Yeah.
Or you want to starve to death in the middle of Joshua or wherever the hell.
Yeah.
In the Hill County country. Hill country, Hill County.
And then you get and then you have the other aspect of it as a risk. We're a rescue. There are a few, very very few actual horse rescues are out there that are actual rescue type deals where they take them in and they fund it themselves. They don't go taking 10 horses and then go beg everybody on Facebook with a GoFundMe account to pay for it.
There you go.
And nobody talking bad about my gun.
What? Why? What happened?
I don't know.
What do you? What do you?
Rescued a bunch of horses asking for free money.
What are you talking about?
No.
Do you know something we don't know?
I think I have a GoFundMe account with my name on it.
For what?
For my rescue horses.
Now what were you talking about? A dishwasher. What happened to the dishwasher?
I don't know. It got.
A kitty cat got rescued from a dishwasher in New Zealand.
What? Yeah. Were you washing the cat?
Yeah.
Give us another name to washing your cat.
A kitten at an animal care facility.
Wait a minute. This cat was at a rescue, and they tried to drown it in the washing machine?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess.
It was trapped
in the dishwasher. It couldn't get out.
Yeah. The kitten in shared a photo of the trapped kitten. In the story of how her head became stuck between a segment of the dishwasher. Kitten in.
Chinese restaurant.
That sounds like a place in Las Vegas.
Kitten in. Yeah.
Come on now, don't be telling no story on Las Vegas. I'll be in Las Vegas in 2 weeks.
Can you go up there and grab one?
Cat?
Hubby.
They got any cats?
Wait a minute.
Look at Las Vegas.
What is going on here? This is the kitten in and the hubby opened the dishwasher. Who's hubby? Hubby opens the dishwasher. And one of the kittens got up underneath and managed to get his head jammed between the plastic of the drawer and the metal on the outside, meaning she couldn't move. The distressed feline meowed in desperation while other kittens watched on. And the kitten end workers sought help while attempting to console the kitten, talking to it in a kitty voice.
It's my favorite line right here.
Eventually, the employees called the local emergency line.
And three firefighters
came. Well, you got all excited when you talk about firefighters.
Three firefighters, not two, not four.
Did you get the calendar?
Three came in.
You get a calendar too with that?
I got a calendar. How?
So I demand the phone and call 111, which is their emergency line. And three lovely firemen came over and got on their knees.
Three lovely firemen.
Whoa, what? Wait a minute. Did you type this up? Is this one of your stories?
Three lovely firemen came around and they got on their knees.
It's a magical.
It did your magical fireman thing, and out you popped.
That's what it says in the story. What? What the?
It was written on the internet by real news publication.
The kitten was Dave in good health, and one of the firefighters planned to take a pair of the kitten home.
Why do you have that twinkle in your eye when you say firefighter like that?
Because he's got the calendar on the wall in there. He's got his month circled.
Man, my birthday.
Ladder 49 on the DVD.
He's going ladder 69 on that deal. How about this? A kitten. There's a cat. If you go Google on YouTube, adventurous cat prepares for horse riding. Stockholm Sweden, a Swedish horse enthusiast, shared a video of a kitten learning the basic skills at horseback riding and not falling off.
The word horseback riding, that's how you know it's not from here. Because we just call it riding horses.
Yeah.
And like when I go to California.
We say riding. We just go
riding.
Yeah,
we're just going to ride horses. And people are like, hey, let's go horseback riding. And I'm like, hey. What? Like as opposed to, I mean, do you ride the horse's neck or leg? Like what else do you ride?
Well, I've seen videos. They do ride other things.
No, not on purpose.
Oh, yeah.
Well, hey. Maybe on purpose.
I think she did on purpose.
All my potential former holy date, I told him about horseback riding.
And they laugh at you?
I didn't ever hope of them again, but anyway.
Well, anyhow, if you Google that in Stockholm, Sweden, you will see a video of a cat riding a horse.
How about that? That squirrel can water ski.
What else you got? You got some stories over there? Tell me about something.
I got Sophia Johnson.
You got snakes on a plane?
Snakes on a plane.
I seen the movie.
We had snakes on a plane like 2 weeks ago.
I've never
and now there's
it.
Snakes on a plane again. Samuel L. Jackson needs to quit trying to leave the country and go talk to these snakes on this plane.
Well, maybe he wasn't voting for Trump. He's one of those.
He's leaving.
He's on his way out.
So he missed the snakes on the plane.
I don't know, but I can tell you that venomous snakes on a stowaway on an Australian police helicopter.
Maybe it was a police snake.
Could have been.
Well, stowaway. Why are they stowing it away? Who's traveling? Gonna be my pet or what?
There's a police chopper in Australia, and I'll tell you right now, said a pair of venomous snakes hitched a ride in a helicopter by hiding in a computer terminal from a radio tower, which I have no idea how this happens, but I bet we'll all find out. The Queensland Police Service said radio electronic service officers who previously removed a snake from a computer terminal in a remote radio tower in the Blue Mountain region in October returned to the same tower November 18th and decided to bring a computer terminal back to McKay for maintenance. Terminal was flown via helicopter to the police station where officers were reunited with an old friend, a snake suspected to be the same one previously removed from a computer casing. The senior constable was summoned to take some pictures of the stowaway. I was called, come and have a look at this, Steve. You might like to take a photo of the snake and its computer home. It's a nerd snake. See, because it likes computers, they think he's a nerd. That's not nice. But, Smith said he was taking a few shots of the computer when he noticed something. A second snake crawling out from an opening. The officer, who had carried the computer terminal all the way from the hillside into the chopper into the car and back and into the office, turned white and sat down. He said a thorough search of the computer terminal was conducted to make sure there were no more serpents inside.
Serpents are evil. It is. They lie about the only tree in the garden.
How many was in the garden?
Only one. Mm. Oh, how many people? Or how many trees?
I don't know. You tell me.
Two people, one snake. I've been to that website.
There's a website for
the
that.
Two snakes that were believed to be venomous red-bellied black snakes. Ooh. They were released into the wilderness of Bukakia.
Bukaki what?
I can't pronounce that. Forget snakes on a plane. In a chopper, no one can hear you scream, Smith joked, and it didn't go over well.
What What in the world's going on? We got any more stories left, or we're done with stories? I got some stories about the money I won in the email and the Bronx.
You got another number to call? We call a number.
How about we call it a show, folks? It is that time, man. So what else is going on? Everybody that's wondering what's going on, because we snuck in here on a non-regular day to throw some stuff at you. So
happy Thanksgiving.
If you're watching before Thursday, which is the regular time, you're like, hey, it's Thanksgiving. It's coming up. If you watch after, you're like, why are they talking about Thanksgiving? That's over. So inside or outside, whichever side you're on, holidays are upon us. Not sure which one you are headed to, but we are headed that direction.
Happy holiday.
Yeah. Get them all in one. You got to get them all together because everybody celebrates different stuff. So you'll make sure you get everybody covered. So with that, for everything else going on with us, where we are, what we're doing, a few things coming up, a few things going down, be sure you follow Pepper Stewart Show on the Facebook. Check it out on the website, on the interweb net. Tex Travis is out there on Farmers Only doing stuff.
On your Facebook.
Eric's out there doing stuff. Check him out. Look him up.
California Kid.
I don't think that's the right guy.
Not a real thing.
That's not a real thing. But there will be a real thing because it'll be out there, and we'll tell you about it. So until then, we will see you guys down the road.